Alright, this is One Piece 1062. Dawn Adventure in the Land of Science. So it looks like there's candle wax or ice. I'm not sure what it is. But everybody's like in Cacao Island. Cacao. They're like stuck frozen in something. Chocolat Town. German didn't do that. I doubt German did that. I don't think they did. Alright, that's page one. Like, testing to death, right? Vegapunk, the Vegapunk. What a fracas. Frashus? Frassic? Fracas? I don't know what that means. A bewildering development. Damn, that much. That robot is huge. It's holding the Sunny, and the Sunny is already huge, the pirate ship. Wow, that thing is humongous. Vegapunk, you're like my role model. I killed it in 2 years. I killed 2 years in your hometown, Baltimore. After going through your lab, there was still a load of stuff I didn't get a chance to look into. It's the giant mech of my dreams. Usopp's like, just how many times bigger than General Frankie is that? Yeah, Luffy would make a big thing. Oh, and Sanji's all into Vegapunk. What a stunning lady. This is page two. She's still there standing, Vegapunk. Just a moment. This is the first time I've heard of Vegapunk being a woman. This is Robin talking. And she looks far too young. Vegapunk has been active for many years. That's true. That's what everyone's talking about. All the people, all the One Piece tubers. Naturally, who said this was the main Stella body? Naturally, this is Vegapunk type. Naturally, who said this was the main Stella body? Stella's in parentheses. Or exclamation points. Yeah, my bad, yeah, exclamation. Wait. Yeah, parentheses are these things. Main body. You're looking at Punk02 Vegapunk. My mind just went blank. Yeah, it says right there, Punk02, like on her chest, right here. This Punk02. The exclamation points the line and the dot. Yeah, it's not parentheses, it's... quotation. There you go. For quotation. Stella's in quotation marks. In any case, we always run through our research funds in a jiffy. Yeah, my mind just went blank. I don't know what's going on. So we'll allow you to skedaddle if you just relinquish your valuables. She wants the money. Lilith. She's gonna let them go if they just give up. Oh no, what's Nami gonna say? These waters are chilly enough without you being cold too. She has those eyes. Has she always had them? No. Her eyes changed. They're already under. Oh man, there's more. Of them underwater, those machines, those robot sharks. Wow, she has a bunch of them, a bear, a giraffe, a tanuki? They're like in fish form. Like, it's like the head of a bear and like chest of a bear and then the second half is like a fish. A wolf. A bull, a lion. Ooh, the lion looks cool. And a deer. Take a gander at the weaponized sea beasts. Who is she talking to? Vegapunk's talking to someone. Lilith, what are you doing? Why do you always insist on looting? Have some pride as a scientist. Who's talking to her? They're the Straw Hat Pirates. A newly dope Emperor crew are not going to meekly surrender. So she thinks they have a bunch of treasure. Weaponized sea beasts. Frankie's in awe, and Usopp's like in awe but scared at the same time. Yeah, but my fear is overwhelming my awe. Usopp says it. Don't underestimate them. Look at the swordsman. Zoro could probably take him on out. I wouldn't be surprised. That's Pirate Hunter Zoro. His bounty is 1.111 billion. See how calm he is? He knows you're in range for him to end you in an instant. The same goes for Devil Child Nico Robin back there. But what can they do against all the sea beasts? Well, they're both ready to attack. Nami's all scared. Who's this talking? The strong can appraise their prey and prioritize the most essential targets first. You should have been more cautious. Let's take a poke. Those imbeciles around them lulled me into a false sense of security. Hey Vegapunk, what's something I want from you? There's something I want from you, so you better play nice. Got it? What does Zoro want? A new eye? What? Zoro wants something from Vegapunk? He's actually asking. He never asks for anything except for, like, alcohol. Maybe it is alcohol. No matter, bring them here. I have an interesting crew. I have an interest in that crew. Punk 01, Dr. Vegapunk, Shaka. The logic? She's talking to herself? There's different Vegapunk. They have... As of this chapter, the old man's voice is only really evident with Lilith. Looks like the Great Saiyan Man's helmet. So you've been here before? Yeah, when I was a kid, it was still... It was just a helmet. Oh no, it's a person wearing a helmet. Yeah, when I was a kid, I was still pretty run-of-the-mill lab at the time, though. It was still a run-of-the-mill... Oh, so when Bonnie was a kid, the lab was still pretty good, like, advanced. So how come you came back to this island? I'm here for answers. I'll have that bastard's life if I don't like what I hear. Vegapunk's the one who turned my dad into a cyborg. He's completely lost his sense of self. So, Bonnie's dad is Kuma. Who said that's awesome, Frankie? It's not awesome. He's completely lost to his sense of self. Oh no, Luffy said that. He doesn't even know, because Frankie's not even there. He doesn't even know who he is anymore. He's nothing but a living weapon now. Sorry, Bogey. It's Bonnie. Yeah, Bonnie. Wow, so that's what Frankie could practically become Kuma. He's kind of like Kuma. I didn't really think about that. But Frankie still has some humanity in him. We made it to the surface. Okay, this is still with Luffy and his chopper, Jinbei and Bonnie. Let's track down some grub. Okay, Bonnie. I forgot I mentioned that I ran into Sabo at Mary Joa. Whatever, I can spill the beans later. Wow. What is all this stuff? Is that a giant robot? Wow, that's a big robot. Looks cool. There's all sorts of things up here. And a space monster? What? There's fish swimming in the sky. There's a big, humongous robot. That looks pretty cool. Looks like, I don't know, like a Mega Man character. There's this humongous alien-looking thing with a big mouth like a crocodile and two eyeballs that are going up, like long eyeballs. Or antennas with eyeballs on top. Yeah, whatever. And two horns. One on the nose and one on the On the neck? What the? He has a lot. Vegapunk has a lot of space stuff there. Like rockets. What in the world? I'll be back after I take one for a ride. Hey. What is all this stuff? It's the giant robot. There's all sorts of things up there and a space monster. What in the world? I'll be back after I take one for the ride. Alright. Take care, Luffy. The chopper's giving him the okay. Take care, Luffy. What? He put his. Luffy threw his arm into the mouth of a space monster. Oh, it's alive? Okay. Oh. It ate Luffy. Oh. Okay, so Luffy's been eaten by the space monster. What's. What? He went through the monster? Is it a. I don't know. He went through the thing. Like, he went through the back of the head. And the monster's still alive. Maybe it's a projection? I don't know. Yeah, he Luffy thought he got swallowed too. A giant parfait. Wow. Humongous ice cream. An ice cream cone, a straw, a bunch of ice cream and fruit on. Oh man, looks good. Look at all the cream. Luffy and Barney are jumping to it. That's Luffy's soulmate right there. And Chopper's going too. he loves sweets. This is like the best combination. Why would they leave food lying around? This has to be a trap. Should be suspicious. They land face first. Oh, it is like a projection. They can't eat it. They went through the ice cream. They went right through it. How can we see it but not touch it? It's so cool to make us hungry like that. Chopper's trying to eat it still. That Bonnie's all sad. He looks like a monkey doing this. Trying to scoop it up. Oh crap, did we die earlier or not notice? There's no way we're ghosts. Who said that? Luffy? Yeah. I've never seen one before, but this parfait must be a hologram. Wow, Luffy just went straight into Gear 5th. What the hell is that? This ticks me off. His hair like turned into fire. Pretty sure that's his Gear 5th. Or something like that. He's just coming as comic relief. It's a 3D image made of light. You see him in comics and science and fiction and stuff. And science fiction stuff. It's just an image. Oh, the space monster. That's why I went right through. That's why I went right through the space monster. The giant robot must be one too. No one can make something like that. Yes, Vegapunk can. Okay, so Chopper found this machine, like a vending machine, but like wider, a wide one. And it has buttons with food on them, like a hamburger and like bread. It's the only ones I recognize. I don't recognize steak. I don't know. Give up already. Everything's on this island's a sham. Oh, it's probably another hologram. That reminds me. Weren't the seas around the island freezing? You'd expect this place to have a similar climate, but so yeah, it's not. So the outside, like around the ocean, there was. Of the island, it was frozen, but inside it's not frozen, it's not like icy. Oh, there's a giant kid. Actually, this is a winter island, but the environmental is set to tropical mode in here. Oh, okay, there's this big giant with two different hair colors. Maybe it's a it might be that girl from the movie, from the recent one, Luffy's sister or his sister. With an island acorn invention, you can specify and regulate. This is the giant talking. The temperature of an area right down to the soil. This one's as big as Kaido. Luffy's getting ready to fight it. It kind of looks like Astro Boy. It has those Astro Boy boot things, and she has like gloves, and she just looks like Astro Boy, like design, and she has like a jetpack. The big giant girl. You're a hollow, hollow thing too, right? Take this! Oh, she punched Luffy in the face. So it's a tropical island. I mean, it's a winter island, but they're able to manipulate the environment, the seasons, the weather. Wow. Man, Luffy got socked in the face. I'm sorry. He's like, yeah, she used... This wasn't for comedic relief. She used Taki. He couldn't even dodge it. And he was like... He was... Maybe he let it happen. I don't know. But he was ready to fight. He was getting ready. He was... Who didn't let us up? It really is real. Okay, so Luffy... The giant slammed Luffy into the vending machine of the food. And it wasn't an illusion. His head hit one of the foods and it's making it a food right now. It's doing it like ice cream. It's dropping it like ice cream. So I don't know what it is. It's probably going to make it just... Oh, it's a burger. Vega Cola. It's a hamburger and fries. A hamburger meal and a drink came out. Who made it? You can touch it. I should have Bonnie got it with her. They're all sharing it. That's funny. Luffy, Bonnie, and Chopper. This chapter is pretty wholesome. Press the next one. Press the next one. They're pressing all the buttons. Steak, omu rice, tonkatsu, cotton candy cake, ramen, fried chicken, hot dogs. It has everything. At least you appreciate my work. That's the unmanned cooking device. So that's another Vegapunk. Did I miss something? Does she have Vega on her? Oh, it says Punk 00 something. 04? I completely missed that. So they've already met three different Vegapunks this chapter. Or they've already revealed three different Vegapunks. Technically four with the previous and the past. They can turn raw ingredients into one of 500 unique dishes in under a minute. Pizza pasta. She's getting annoyed. The make do with what you've got mode is the best. But I can't be too happy since the lack of competent engineers means that this bucket of bolts can't be mass produced. It's following the blueprints that damn hard. So they can't mass produce it because nobody could follow the blueprints. Apparently the blueprints are too hard. Really pisses me off. Oh, she just... The island Aracorn is in the same damn boat. Its sensors can monitor living creatures. She hit something. The island Acorn is in the same damn boat. Its sensors can monitor living creatures, and it could tame the weather if we just had a bit more money. The island Aircon. I can't read. That's why I play Yu-Gi-Oh. The island Aircon is in the same damn boat. Its sensors can monitor. Aircon, the AC? And it could tame the damn weather if we just had a bit more money. There are endless ideas, but not enough resources. And she was able to punch a hologram. The thing Luffy couldn't punch, the space monster, she was able to punch it. Bonnie saw that, but Luffy and Chopper are distracted by the waffle shrimp fried shrimp. So you can't hit light, even with Haki? Because Vegapunk is saying, of course. Another Vegapunk? Okay, so P25 Vegapunk, another Vegapunk is revealed. Of course, my photonic gloves make it possible to physically interact with light. So, Haki doesn't work with light? Maybe same thing with darkness? You need something to fight darkness? Perception shapes your sense of reality, but touching a projected object turns that on its head, doesn't it? So that girl isn't real. These these gloves. I was in fight light. Hit light. Debates on what makes something real are as old as time. What? It's something you'll have to decide for yourself, but I consider the matter settled. So just what are you? Luffy and Bonnie are cheersing. Even Jinbei's eating some chicken. And he asks, so what are you? Me? Just your resident. A scientific genius for hire. Dr. Vegapunk. What? Dr. Vegapunk Atlas. Wrath. That's the one that looks like 06. It's the one that looks like Astro Boy. What the hell? That's a lie. That's a total lie. That's Bonnie talking. Luffy, you're Vegapunk? I've heard that name. Kobe told me about you. Luffy remembers that. New world. Okay. We're at the world government. It's a ship. It completely transitioned to another part of the world. New world, so what now? Just keep listening, Luffy. Oh, the CP9, CP0. Vegapunk is technically still a single individual, but his genius, this is Kaku talking from CP0, CP9, but his genius is second only to his busyness when there's not enough time. They say you're as busy as a beaver right now, right? Well, imagine if there were more than one. That was his grand idea, to split up into six people. So there's six Vegapunks, so they could work faster, make things like doing a shadow clone jutsu to learn things faster. I think Naruto did that. In Japanese, the idiom is cats. In other words, all six of these satellites are also Dr. Vegapunk, and I'm the weird one for thinking that sounds impossible. That's Luffy talking. Geniuses are such a pain. Desire your yoke, Vegapunk 6, Vegapunk 5, Wrath Atlas. Punk 4, Wisdom, Pythagoras, Punk 3, Edison, Punk 2, Lilith, Punk 1, Shaka. Alright, so Vegapunk, Oda made a mistake with Atlas's number. Wow, already 14 pages, this is a info-packed chapter. New world. So, what now? Oh, crap. So, I'm already 14 chapters in. Damn, this is a really info, nicely packed chapter with panels. Panel 15. Oh, Kuma isn't behind them. In short, our assignment is to return this problem child back to Egghead. Then while taking care not to damage any of the lab's precious assets, we're to eliminate every last Vegapunk. Wow, Kuma's like got angel wings now and has a star on his chest. So they got a pacifista, or whatever those new pacifistas are called, and they got That chick from CP0, Sydney, Siri, I forgot her name. Sissy? I think Sissy? Luffy, Rob Luffy, and Kaku were there. They're going with Kuma. They're gonna wear masks too, but they're gonna notice Kuma with his nose. They're gonna be like, is that Usopp? Oh my god, that's a funny bit just waiting to happen. Because they have their masks on the table. So we're not meant to kill the single most useful man in the world. I wonder if this has something to do with the recent Lulucia incident. Someone with your instincts like yours should know better than to question these things. Agreed. Don't get us in any hot water, Luffy. A calculated plan. Damn. Yeah, but can they even do anything to Luffy? Like, he's pretty much... Maybe the Pacifista can. Who knows, maybe Rob Lucci was just taken off guard. So they're gonna split up? Will Kaku and Zoro have a rematch? Yeah, I was hoping they color it. That's cool. Damn, that was a pretty good chapter. Info packed. It was all about Vegapunk. So many reveals. So that confirms that Admiral Borsellino Kizaru, Admiral Kizaru, he's not a Vegapunk. I was like, a lot of people thought he was gonna be a Vegapunk, but apparently he's not. Well, have they haven't showed all the Vegapunks yet, right? They showed one, two. Okay, they showed the one that they showed one time. I didn't really describe it. The Astro Boy one, Lilith, the one with where Frankie's at. The giant kid one. The one with the Great Saiyan hat. I think they've only shown five. They've only revealed five. They haven't shown the sixth one yet. Yeah. P25? Is that really one of them? So, I don't know if that one of them they revealed was a Vegapunk. So, I think they've only revealed four or five. They haven't revealed all of them yet. Oh, this Vegapunk card. They're all females. So that was a really good chapter. So I thought this guy was gonna be Vegapunk. Maybe he is, who knows? Alright, well, that was the live reaction. I hope you liked it.